Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank. Type of money you gon' need a sight. The type of money you gon' need a buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money she gon' let you put it in the fight. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low.
What's good, rap legends? It's Brianna, and welcome back to another hair video. As y'all can see, I am in my bathroom currently. And today is all about my wash day routine. I'm just gonna lay down a couple basic things that I do, and then I'm gonna get into it and let y'all just watch the process. My shampoo that I will be using is the Volume from Ozzy, as you can see here. I don't think I'm gonna condition today, and the reason that I kind of wanted to film this was just because this is actually a new method that I've been doing past couple of weeks, and I think I'm gonna start sticking with this instead of having to wash my hair in the shower. Because let's be real, guys, I hate washing my hair in the shower because the hot water ends up running out, because not only do I have to wash my hair, which is a lot, I don't know if you guys noticed, but I have a lot of hair and it's very thick. And aside from my hair, I have to wash my body after. It's just a lot to do. Like, the wash day really is a process. Stop talking and let y'all watch how I do it. So before I get into the wash, this is basically what my hair looks like before. I am now just kind of pre-stretching out my hair, if that's what you want to call it, and taking down my scrunchie in my front from my previous style. I also wanted to mention that, as you guys may see right here, and if you follow me on my Instagram, you know that my last hairstyle involved some coloring, and when I wash out my hair, the water is gonna be blue, so don't be alarmed by that. I just wanted to let y'all know that I have color in the top of my hair, and I'm just gonna go ahead and wash that out. So for my wash, as y'all can see, I am using my graduation class of 2018 cup, and I'm just pouring water over my head. So here's the actual gag. In the end, I ended up just running my head under, like, the actual water of where the faucet in my tub is. But for these next couple of clips, you're kind of just looking at me attempting to rinse my hair using that one large plastic cup that I had, and now I am just attempting to wring out all of the water. Again, the color is still in my hair, as you can see in the top, but once I finish this step, then you'll kind of see what I do next for it. So now that my hair is proportionally less wet, I am going to start shampooing, starting with the front. And the front is actually not, my hair isn't or wasn't very dirty, but I do want to get the color out, so I am mainly focusing on the front of my hair and really scrubbing and really just colliding the shampoo around the perimeter of my hair and rubbing it into my scalp, as you can see. And the blue is slowly starting to disappear. If you kind of look, and my curls are starting to pop out a little more, and I'm just really being sure I'm getting in the roots of my scalp, because when I did apply this color to my hair, it was all up on my edges and in my roots. So like I mentioned before, I am mainly focusing on just getting the color all out of the front of my hair, but I am also focusing on shampooing the back proportion of my hair and all around my perimeter. As y'all are witnessing, and not only do I do my scalp, but because it's not just color in my scalp, I am flourishing it all throughout my hair. I also wanted to mention that I no longer will be washing my hair in sections like before, just because washing my hair as a whole is the easiest method for me. And now we're back in the tub, so we could go ahead and rinse out all the shampoo, and y'all can see all the color coming out of my hair. Gonna go ahead and wring that out real quick. For a second, I was still using my cup to try and rinse out all my hair, but as you can see, it was not working. I still had shampoo in the back of my hair, so I finally gave in and was like, you know what, let me just go ahead and use this faucet, okay? So I went ahead and rinsed out all the shampoo from the back of my hair.
I have no more color in the front, and I am wringing out my hair total and just making sure I don't have like a bunch of water left in my scalp. Okay, and now that I am out of the tub, I am going ahead and wiping away all of the excess water that's dripping out from the perimeter of my scalp before I go ahead and head into the final step. Last but not least, you're going to want to use a cotton t-shirt, not a towel, but a cotton t-shirt to dry your hair with. Cotton, because it soaks up not only the water, using a towel does actually drain out the fibers in your hair, which make it dry once again and doesn't leave any moisture. As you guys are looking at me using my cotton t-shirt to dry out my hair. Now for this part, there's no fancy tying or nothing, but all I do is I twist my cotton t-shirt in the front, throw it up in the back, and tuck the ends. And boom, you have it right there.
All right, Rep Legends, that is the end of this 2020 wash day routine. Thank you guys so much for watching. If y'all want to know how I get my hair to stretch out, I actually made a video about a month ago, so a little bit ago, about how I stretch my hair overnight and basically just the process after I am all done washing it. You can go check that out. The link is in my description box below, but my Instagram is natural.breezy18. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you in my next. Okay, bye.